Duvelisib is a new oral PI3 kinase inhibitor that's been approved for the treatment of chronic lymphocytic leukemia and follicular lymphoma. It's an inhibitor of both the delta and gamma isoforms. Now, this is distinct from other approved agents where they either inhibit both the delta and alpha isoform or just the delta isoform alone. The gamma isoform may be important because it extends to the microenvironment where the cell-cell interactions are important in keeping malignant cells alive. And so this is a distinguishing part of duvelisib. Now, the DUO trial was a randomized phase 3 trial comparing duvelisib as a single agent to ofatumumab in patients who've had at least one prior therapy with chronic lymphocytic leukemia. This study showed a tremendous improvement in progression-free survival over ofatumumab, especially when we look at those patients who had two prior therapies. The magnitude of improvement in progression-free survival was greater. And this is what led to the approval of duvelisib in chronic lymphocytic leukemia in the United States. Now, we've recently looked at some important questions in this trial concerning adverse event management. All these agents are associated with certain adverse events. And the concern is that if patients remain on the drug, then these adverse events will worsen. What we found is that if you hold the drug or reduce the dose, people that were managed in this way, and I think appropriately, they had just as good an outcome than those people that never had any dose interruption. And I think this should be important for doctors and their patients because they can now, with confidence, know that by holding the drug appropriately when they're seeing some of these adverse events, that their outcome will be just as good for those patients than if they tried to keep them on and had all the side effects that we really want to avoid. PI3 kinase inhibitors are an important addition to our armamentarium for patients with CLL. Now, the treatment paradigms for CLL are sort of really solidifying around ibrutinib being a frontline agent for patients. We also, of course, have venetoclax. But for patients who've had two prior therapies, our choices are really limited. And this is where I think the PI3 kinase inhibitors are going to be very, very helpful, and duvelisib in particular. It's this patient population that we do not have great other options. And this is an effective agent in those settings.